We have a task today. Our task, I've decided, is to paint this room blue. And the tools we could have are a hammer, a saw, and a screwdriver. Best of British luck. I mean, what do you think the result would be if we tried to do that? Huh? What's missing, by the way? Paint! Paintbrush! So we got all the wrong tools for the job. Now, what's the point of this silly metaphor, or simile, or whatever the heck form of speech it is? The point is that in our society, well-meaning, well-intended families, cultures, religions notwithstanding, we've all been invested with the wrong tools for dealing with grief. Let me say that again. We've all been invested with the wrong tools for dealing with grief. Grief is a normal and natural reaction to loss, yet almost everything we learn about dealing with grief is not normal, not natural, and not healthy. And when you learn tools when you're little, you carry them off into the future. One universal truth I can say, without fear of contradiction, is that in order to be an adult, you first have to be a child. Anybody want to argue? Can't argue. Okay, so if I start here and at my most early years and formative time, I am pummeled with information that says feeling bad is bad, to be sad is bad, and it's hounded over and over. There's a study that was released about 15 years ago that indicated by the time a child in our society is 15 years old, they've had more than 21,000 inputs that suggest A, they shouldn't feel bad, and if they do, they shouldn't show anyone else. Okay? Now, how true is this? How true is it culturally that this idea, it takes root? Now, we can do this as a test. We're going to create the Torrance Memorial Choir here, the Thelma McMillan Choir. Are you ready? I'm going to say a sentence, and I'm going to leave out the last word, and I want you to sing out the last word, and we'll find out if isolation is true for grieving people in our society. Ready? Laugh and the whole world laughs with you. Cry and you cry.
Oh.
Wow, Chuck, did you get that? What a chorus. We could go on the road with this. But the sadness, the scariness is that you all knew that. And to whatever degree, and I'm not going to attack you, you might believe it. The truth is we all learned that by the time we're this big, or things like that.